got great news from Shay today. Our recent house reno down the street is officially under contract for $75,000, which means we have our first comp on the block. And with those funds, we can buy our next project. Shay says she's found the perfect challenge and it's right down the street.
So here's the house.
It's so cute.
Right? It's a ranch. You have 3-bedroom, 2-bath, 1,000 square feet.
You had me at 2 bathrooms.
Huge picture window, and then the roof is new.
That's awesome. That's a big cost saver, too.
And it's priced at $32,000.
Most of the houses we buy only cost us a couple thousand bucks, but this house is much larger, and it's a highly sought-after 3-bedroom, 2-bath.
The bigger the house, the bigger the risk. There's more construction, there's more design, but there's not always a bigger budget for us to work with, especially if the buy-in is 32 grand.
Okay, this is it.
Oh, wow. Nice. This is a huge open layout.
It is.
This is an amazing amount of light to come into this
house.
Right,
and then with that side window, it helps make it feel nice and open.
Woof.
Why would they drop the ceiling?
I know, I was just gonna say that. The whole house just feels like a camper to me.
It does.
But the kitchen space is massive.
It is.
I like this. I like it a lot. But the hallway is a bit. I hate hallways. They're such a waste of space.
But look, it's super long. Like the house is like never ending.
You could. Should we bowl? Unfortunately, the way this house is laid out, it doesn't look like there's much we can do on the configuration, so I'm gonna have to kind of live with it. But we're gonna rip all that nasty paneling out. I think it'll help a lot just lightening it up in there. It's just icky.
So this is a huge, huge bedroom.
This room is massive compared to most of the homes in the area, and it has an ensuite bath. This room alone could sell the house if given the right design.
So how do you feel about it?
I like that it has potential.
So priced at $32,000, what would you guys' reno budget be for this place?
I mean, I'm looking around. It looks like the electrical is updated. So probably, I would say, around $35,000. What do you think that we could sell it for?
I feel pretty confident that we can get around $100,000.
Okay, sweet. That's amazing.
That's awesome.
That's really good.
100 grand is extremely high for this block. But now that we have a comp down that street at about $100 per square foot, I feel comfortable asking 6 figures here.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
What is your plan for this house?
In here, all cabinets are gonna go. The drop ceiling is gonna go. So inexplicably, they
decided that, you know what? The ceiling is too high. I have too much ceiling space.
You always wonder why there's a drop ceiling. What are they hiding?
Most of the time it's water damage, which can easily add 10 grand or more to our budget.
Since we paid way more for this place and there's more square feet to reno than usual, any unexpected expense can have a terrible domino effect on the budget.
Oh, there is something.
Oh God.
Is that a water leak?
Yeah, it's solid.
Okay, all right. I keep waiting for it.
So, it turns out, nothing.
Nothing. You just have bad taste. You're not even trying to hide anything.
Normal wall?
Yeah.
Ah, good, okay, awesome. Overall, underneath its terrible shell, the bones in this house look really good. That's a big relief. Since the house costs $32,000, we only have about 30 grand for renovations, less than we have on the smaller desert mod house. So it's gonna be a challenge to make over this much square footage with this little cash.
Can't wait to do this. I'm taking it very, very mid-century vibe. Like, very, very mid-century.
This is gonna be my mid-century museum house. Clean lines, graphic black and white finishes, complemented by colorful geometric art pieces and metallic accents. When it's done, it's gonna feel like you walked into an art gallery.
That hallway is like a runway.
I assume that's how you'll sashay down to the kitchen every morning?
In this house, yes.
I usually hate halls, but
if there's a mirror at the end, you know. If a house must have a hall, then I must sashay. Especially with that mirror. That mirror at the end is just like,
runway, runway, run, 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 runway.
Runway.
We'll be right back. We're down to the final design projects, but unfortunately, we're out of cash. This house is 300 square feet larger than the Desert Mod House and has an extra bath, so we've already gone $5,000 over budget renoing all of the extra space. So I've resorted to a 99-cent solution to give the rest of the house the designer art museum vibe I'm going for.
Whoa. I see why you wanted me to buy so much tape.
Yeah.
So what's what and all this?
So everything that is tape will stay white.
Oh, okay.
And then just sort of roll over it.
Mm-hmm. Everything black. Else will be black.
I always loved Alice in Wonderland. That was my favorite movie growing up when I was a kid. When she falls down the rabbit hole and all the black and white patterns and stuff. That'll be the down the rabbit hole bathroom.
That's pretty crazy.
Over in the living room, I'm doing another paint feature that only requires some time and painter's tape.
I want this one to wrap all the way around the three walls.
What is it gonna be, shapes?
Or is it triangles, and then it'll be echoed out with lines.
So this is like, you remember those mod dresses from the 60s?
I don't, but.
Back in the 60s, color blocking was a really popular thing. Off of that spun the mini mod, which was a super cute little miniskirt dress. That's kind of the inspiration for this.
Open houses in one day.
I feel confident.
We never have as much time as we'd like, but the stress is always worth it. We brought the soul back to a house that had been given up on.
Down.
Up.
Right there.
Sweet.
You good?
Does it work?
Oh, I love it.
We finally got this place beehive free and feeling like a home again.
Tomorrow we'll find out if people like what we've created enough to pay double than most of the other comps on the street. When we got this house, it looked like the inside of a 1970s RV.
It was very dark, very dungeony. I think we did a good job of opening it up, giving it some new life. The inside, I really kind of wanted to give you like almost like a museum vibe where there's just lots of great art, lots of great lighting, something that's, you know, maybe not expected in a traditional home, but.
Art can be pretty personal, so it's a gamble, but hopefully my vision will resonate and a buyer will love this as much as I do.
Oh my God. I think I just walked into a museum.
The designer, this is his original art, including this gorgeous accent wall.
I love the lines and the triangular color.
That's dope.
Right?
Yes.
I love the little nook area. Mm-hmm. It's really nice.
So I'm gonna show you the kitchen.
Okay.
This is gorgeous.
Right?
This is so nice. What is it made out of?
These countertops are actually concrete.
Oh my goodness.
And the guys put this finish over where it looks like leather.
I can see myself here.
Yeah.
Good.
Check out this spacious bedroom.
This to me, I think, is the main selling feature of this home. Is this
nice?
Gigantic main bedroom.
Oh my, this is my room.
Custom headboard.
Whose idea was this?
That would be me. I love color.
I love color too. Great. And this is awesome.
I think we found your home.
Nice walk-in shower. Large vanity.
And then when you get out the shower, you might as well just walk down here like a runway and model.
The open house went great.
I think it played well. People seem to really love the lighting. They like the art everywhere. That's great. I think what I was kind of going for resonated and people seem to love it.
They loved it so much, we are now under contract for the asking price after only 5 days on the market.